first of all, just how's life been in Pullman, and how's the transition for you coming from Florida Atlantic?
The transition probably became official this past Saturday. Mm-hmm. Our dog and our guinea pig finally showed up. I had three daughters, 13, 10, and 7. They started school last week, so this is week 2 of school. They've been here for about 3 weeks, so really, the job kind of got more real once the family got here, because it's really not real when you're just working and going and spending time in the office and just seeing as many people as possible. Now the life part starts, where you got to actually go to your real, more important job of being a dad and a husband. So, but it's fun. The people are awesome. The institution's great. The passion Cougs have for Washington State is a lot like our alma mater. Mm-hmm. It's the energy and just the vibe you get. It's fun to be a part of an institution like this.
Yeah, what has been your first impression of the fan base? And I know you talked about the energy and the passion for it, but were you a little bit surprised when you came out here to how passionate this fan base is?
Well, reputationally, you knew how passionate they were, but I've been fortunate to get out and meet a full array of former student athletes, supporters, season ticket holders, alumni, and you know, a couple of commonalities. One, no Cougs likes to lose. They take a lot of pride in their institution. A lot of them have, you know, most of them, if not all of them, had transformative experiences being undergrads at Washington State. So when you package the whole thing up, the loyalty is real, and the responsibility we have in athletic department to steward that loyalty and make sure that we have an athletic program that represents our institution in the stature and manner in which it deserves to be represented.
What is the state of the Washington State athletic program right now as you come in?
Really good. My predecessor, Bill Moose, I tell everyone he did two really, really important things for his successor. Number one, he hired some really good people that love and care for the institution and really will do anything, no matter what time of day it is, to better the athletic program, better the institution. And our department's wired in a way which the only way we'll do it is the right way. The second thing is he made some serious investments into our facilities, which give us a foundation to be able to do something great. Our business is unique that football is the economic engine. It does provide a window in terms of more opportunity for your athletic program and other sports, so it has to be stabilized. So when you look at the work done on Martin Stadium and the football operations building, hiring a coach like Mike Leach, President Schultz locking him in for the next few years, we're in a really good place with football. Most of our sports are doing well. We just made a big hire with women's basketball, mm-hmm. but we're in a position right now where it's only one or two sports that we got to get going, and really the whole portfolio of sports will be really in the upper half of the Pac-12.
Yeah, and I do want to touch on the stabilization of the football program, because that's been the biggest growth that we witnessed under Moose. And just to the fan base, they are passionate. They want to see a lot of winning across the board. How important is it as an athletic director to know that the football program has been stabilized and money's been infused into that program to get this program constantly to a bowl game, something, you know, 5 years ago they were not doing and had a huge drought in?
Yeah, you know, I remember my first 2 weeks here, and you get the sense that people were disappointed that we were 9-4, mm-hmm. Losing our last two games. And I reminded everyone, 9-4 disappointed is better than 4-8 miserable. So I think everyone understands the investment that needs to be made to have a competitive athletic program and a competitive football program. It's probably more my job for people to understand that it's the reinvestment. There's no finish line to this deal. Every school that we're competing against is constantly figuring out how can we improve our football program and our athletics program. So we are one of those institutions. Like I said, I've yet to meet a Coug that wants to lose. I've yet to meet a Coug that doesn't cherish those Saturdays in Pullman. In which, you know, magic happens when you come to our campus. We have people that come in on Thursday nights that open up their mobile homes or campers and, you know, for their friends and family. And it's a reunion and connectivity with campus and memories. And the band comes out and takes the field, and you have all this energy and passion, and we haven't gotten to kickoff yet. But those four quarters matter, because they're emblematic of, they're a source of pride for our institution. So I think it's just making sure everyone understands that we're at a certain point now. We have a responsibility to keep the ball moving forward, and a lot of it is how we invest and the revenue streams we create for our athletic program. we have an opportunity because of our leadership of President Schultz and the football head coach we have with Mike Leach to do something really special and keep giving Coach Leach the tools to get us to a Pac-12 championship. These things are not easy. He's in a highly competitive league, but really the trajectory we're on as a football program, we're in really good shape, and we'll keep this thing moving forward as long as possible.
Yeah, and touching on the football program, seeing Mike Leach when you got this job, was that very helpful, and did that make this position very desirable for you when it opened up?
You know, it was nice even the first time you talked. Well, his resume speaks for itself. You know, he's an elite head coach. He's won at Texas Tech. He has a system that him and Hal Mumme changed college football with in the air raid. So he has an expertise at a level that not many coaches have. And really indicative of that is the family tree of coaches that have worked for him. So I think it's more when you get here and you spend time with him and just kind of understand and get a better understanding of how he's a CEO, how he, you know, how self-aware he is. And really, probably the thing, maybe it's not the quality of coach he is, probably the most reassuring thing is to see how well Pullman fits in. He loves this place. He loves walking to work. He loves his coffee shop. He loves his staff. He loves his office. He's got the freedom to be who he is, and we want him to be who he is, because every great coach is who he is, who he or she is on the respective programs or the respective campuses. So I think the reassuring thing is knowing that he loves Pullman. He loves Washington State. This is where he wants to be, and allows us to really think long term on what we do to help fortify his program.
And then financially, it's been well documented that the athletic department is in a deficit. Does that hamper any projects that you guys are looking forward to? And how have you guys attacked that deficit?
Well, we're no different than most colleges and the universities that support FBS football. Mm-hmm. Your alma mater, probably, I think they start every year $30 million in debt. Yeah. Their revenue streams are, though, very different. So for us, our focus is, all right, we made investments here in the past. Elson Floyd, Bill Moose, if Martin Stadium was a $75 million investment to renovate and enhance, Bill Moose got us a $300 million stadium for $75 million. That's a pretty sound investment. We got to go pay those bills. We recognize that, but we also got to be smart about the revenue streams that we're creating, and that is in itself what the difference is. You can't cut your way to prosperity. There's a gentle balance. We are going to be responsible stewards of our resources, mm-hmm. but we also have to be smart business people and understand that through fundraising, corporate sponsorship, ticket sales, whatever it may be, we need to be smart about generating new revenue streams for athletics.
Yeah, and coming from FAU, one of the things that you bring to the table or brought to the table there was fundraising. That has always been a plan of attack for you. How have you noticed the Cougar Athletic Fund throughout your time here, and how do you feel like the alumni base is connecting with the athletic program?
Well, fundraising is a team sport, and it's more a reflection of the passion that people in and around the institution have, and having a quality fundraising staff. So everyone knows how much people love Washington State, and then even with our CAF staff, our numbers are up pretty significant. We're almost up seven figures in our annual fund right now, and we have a really good team that loves Washington State and understands that, like any great athletic program, there's a correlation with the quality of your fundraising staff and the results to the quality of your athletic program and the results. We have to, that's really our best opportunity to find new revenue streams and be able to do more for our student athletes. So we're in a good place right now. It's also one of those things that there's no finish line. We got to keep, you know, we're not in a situation that we can go close a big gift and kick our feet up for a couple weeks and enjoy the win. We're win and move on. So, but we will keep getting wins in fundraising, and we'll keep adding to this program. The opportunity is there. The passion of people are there. The people want to support Washington State. So we just got to make sure that we're meeting people and making sure they understand how they can impact us and help us in the future.
And then on your checklist, what are a couple of things that you have in the horizon as facilities that maybe you want to bring to the athletic program and whatever program that may be?
Probably one and two that we've already been very public about is baseball is first and foremost. We've renamed our renovation and enhancement project to Project BTO. BTO stands for Back to Omaha. If you look at the tradition of our program, we've been to Omaha four times. We've been to the NCAA tournament, I think 16 or 18 times, or it's our oldest varsity sport that we have. The only debate in the Pac-12 isn't who the best player is of all time, because that's John Olerud, and he's a Coug. The debate's who's the second best player. So history is on our side with baseball. Its rightful place is in postseason in Omaha. there's geographic challenges being in the Pac-12 because half the schools are in warm weather climates. So we have to be smart about that. We have to give our baseball program a facility in which it can recruit and develop student athletes. So we're getting close to on that project relative to football and really baseball and all of our other sports. Is we have to replace that bubble. Mm-hmm. We need an indoor practice field, so that is priority number two. So we're hopefully the way this thing timelines is we're going to get done to priority one relatively soon here. We're going to move to priority two, and but I get the sense after being here for even 2.5 months, there are a lot of people that want to support that and understand that that is the next thing that we need. So once we get through those things, there's probably some sport renovations for locker rooms that we have to do. We'll focus on a couple other projects, but there's no finish line for that as well. I mean, we'll keep reinvesting in ourselves.
And then you made your first biggest hire, I would say, at least on the job, fill in the vacancy there, women's basketball, with Cami Etheridge. And what can you tell me about her, and what gave her the edge in the coaching search?
Well, we need to do something different with women's basketball, and history has shown that you can do something at Washington State if you have an extraordinary coach that fits us. And whether it's Mike Price, Mike Leach, Dick Bennett, Tony Bennett, history shows you get the right person, you can do a lot of great things. So when you look at who we are and where we need to get to, Cami Etheridge just checked all the boxes. She is probably one of the most decorated college basketball players of all time. She has won at the highest level. She's won every award you can. She's won a gold medal in the Olympics. She won at Northern Colorado as a head coach. She's their reigning conference champion. She's a reigning coach of the year. And she's got a chip on her shoulder. And she wants to be able to do something and do something special at Washington State. So she fits us perfect. I think she gives us an edge. Pac-12 basketball, women's basketball, is one of the, depending who you ask, it's either number two in all of women's college basketball. So we need a coach that when he or she walks into the room, they command respect because they're recruiting against them 365 days a year, and they're competing against coaches that are going to be in the Hall of Fame on the court. And Cami definitely commands respect, and she's not going to take a backseat to anyone in that coach's room.
And then on the other side with the men's program, I think the most irritable subject for a lot of Washington State fans is what's happened with the men's basketball program. What's the state of that, and what do you want to see from this program heading into next year? Obviously, you've already given your vote of confidence to Ernie Kent for the following season, but what are you looking for in Ernie and his team moving forward?
Well, Ernie and I had a great meeting at the end of the year, and he's disappointed in the season, and he's been in this business long enough. He knows exactly where we're supposed to be, how he believes we need to get there, and he's got a plan to do it. So my job now from this point on is we're going to support Ernie as much as possible. I'm going to urge all the Cougs to support our men's basketball program as much as possible, because take whatever opinion you have about our coach, we got 15 young men that are wearing our logo that deserve 100% of our support because they're representing us every time they take the court. So Ernie knows what he needs to do. I'm optimistic, and I think it's going to be fun to watch this season develop. Because as long as we have the offseason that we think we can have, which is a huge part of this deal, and then he's going to have to recruit and get a couple other young people to join the team. But the way it's stacking up now, I think we're going to surprise a lot of people next year.
And then finally, just what are you most excited about in the future, taking this role and completing that first year as you're only, of course, 2.5 months in?
Really, the state of Washington State is awesome. I mean, the university, this is a unique time period. It's, you know, I tell everyone I came here for three specific reasons. Number one, to work for the best president in college athletics, in Kirk Schultz. Two, you can do great things if you have a passionate alumni base, and we don't take a backseat to anyone at Washington State. And the third thing is Pullman's a wonderful place to raise a family. And like we had talked about, I got three young daughters at home and a wife that is in this to the end with me. So I need a great place to raise them. And the exciting thing is now just putting some roots in and getting to learn more and understand our place better and trying to figure out how we as the athletic department can write this next great chapter of Washington State history. We've had so many great things that have happened, and we've always prided ourselves in being the place that did more with less. Well, we're going to step into a new area for Washington State. We're going to do more with more. And I think our people are going to be really pleased with what we're going to be able to do, because we have a great, great quality of people that staff our athletic program, and we're overshadowed by these awesome student athletes that represent us every day. So the package is there. We know our responsibility. The greatest days of our athletic program are right in front of us, and we're going to go on this journey to go discover what those days are.